In this video, we will discuss about gunning splints. Gunning splints are the modified dentures designed to reduce and fix and stabilize the mandibular fractures, especially in edentulous patients. Only in edentulous or partially edentulous patients. Okay, that is the definition. Then coming to the indications. As I said, gunning splints are utilized to reduce and to stabilize and to immobilize the fractured mandible in edentulous patients. So indications, there are two main things. It should be done on the mandible and in the edentulous patients. Okay, because the problem with edentulous fractures is that the blood supply is already compromised. You know that the mandible gets its blood supply from two sources. The first one is inferior alveolar artery and the second one is periosteal supply and muscle attachments. In younger age or a young patient, the main source of blood supply to the mandible is from the inferior alveolar artery. But as age increases, due to the thrombosis or atherosclerosis of blood vessels, the blood supply from the inferior alveolar artery gets reduced. So in an older patient or in edentulous mandible, in an older patient, the main source of blood supply to the mandible is the periosteal attachments and muscle attachments. So in edentulous fractures, you can't go for excessive periosteal stripping. That has to be done in the cases of open reduction. If you do excessive periosteal stripping, it will compromise the blood supply to the fractured or that mandible and it will result in the delayed healing. So we generally, wherein possible, we generally manage edentulous fractures with close reduction. For that close reduction, we are going to use the gunning splints. Okay, that is the indication. Fractured mandible, edentulous patient. Then coming to the contraindications, if there is unfavorable displacement of the posterior segment of the mandible, that means maybe the angle, mandibular angle or ramus fractures, if there is excessive displacement, unfavorable displacement, generally gunning splints are utilized for edentulous mandibular fractures in dental bearing area, dentate mandible. That means generally for the edentulous body fractures or parasymphysis, symphysis fracture or some cases of angle fractures also. Okay, so when there is excessive unfavorable displacement of the posterior fragment, then it is not indicated. And the second contraindication is if there is severe loss of bone and soft tissue, that is due to the comminution of fracture. In those cases also, it is not recommended. And the third contraindication is that if there is severe atrophy of maxilla and mandible, that means the maxilla or mandible due to the post-extraction resorption, okay, if there is too thin bone, then you can't insert the wire. That is, you can't fix the gunning splints to the maxilla or mandible. The wires may cut through the bone. They will come out. Okay, in those cases also, that is severe atrophy of maxilla and mandible. In those cases also, you cannot use the gunning splints. Then coming to the splint fabrication, we can use dentures. That is already patient using denture, existing dentures of the patient can be modified as gunning splint. Okay, after that you may take fresh impressions. You may take fresh impressions of the maxilla and mandible and you can prepare the gunning splint from that. Otherwise you can use commercially available prefabricated gunning splints also. So there are three types. Okay, we can use any one. but generally we are going to modify the dentures or we are going to prepare the denture. Okay, for modification of existing denture we are going to extract the central incisors, lateral and canine from the maxilla and mandible. You can see in this diagram. Okay, so these are the models. Okay, this is the maxillary denture, mandibular denture. What we have done, we have extracted canine to canine in maxilla and mandible also. This anterior opening is for feeding purposes. Patient can anything drink or any can eat. Okay, from this opening. So first step in the modification is to extract the canine to canine teeth in maxilla and mandible. The next step is 2 to 3 hooks. Okay, 2 to 3 hooks. You can see in this diagram these red color ones are the hooks. 2 to 3 hooks per quadrant. That is, after extraction you have maxillary right and left quadrants, mandibular right and left quadrants. In each quadrant you have to fix 2 to 3 screws with a self-cure acrylic. Those hooks will be utilized for the purpose of intermaxillary fixation. You can see here, these are the intermaxillary wires, ligating wires, for the purpose of intermaxillary fixation. After that you may cut a groove on the palatal aspect also for the engagement of these wires, for the engagement of this paralellar wire or circummandibular wiring. You can cut a groove on the palatal aspect also, or alternatively, instead of these hooks you can use the arch bar also. Cut a groove in the buccal flanges and attach a arch bar with the self-cured acrylic. With that arch bar also you can ligate the wires, you can do the intermaxillary fixation. This is regarding modification of the already existing dentures. Then coming to the impressions, first you have to take upper and lower impressions. These impressions will reproduce the fractured fragments. So after pouring models, you have to cut the model at the fractured side and correct the malalignment. Okay, after correcting you have to pour the dentures, that is base plates, and on that base plate you have to fabricate occlusal rims with leaving anterior opening as we saw in this case. Okay, on that occlusal rim at the fabrication time of only we can attach the hooks or we can attach the arch bar also. Okay, those occlusal rims and those fabricated dentures can be used as gunning splints. Gunning means it is the first gunning is the scientist who gave this procedure first time. That is, in the name of his we have named it gunning splints. Okay, after that prefabricated, commercially available prefabricated, we first choose the size and then we can use it. So this is regarding splint fabrication. Then coming to the operative technique, how will you do it? So first thing, we have now maxillary gunning splint and mandibular gunning splint. First we'll fix maxillary gunning splint. We fix it by the procedure of paralveolar wiring. Okay, you can see in these diagrams, in serial diagrams. Okay, so this is the maxilla occlusal aspect. Take a short awl, bone awl. Okay, bone awl, and insert it from the buccal side approximately at the canine eminence. First identify the canine eminence, then take a awl and insert it from the buccal aspect so that it paces downward towards the palate. Okay, so its direction of action, its direction should be downward like this, and it should face and it should come out through the palate on the medial aspect. Okay, so using rotary boring action like this, rotary boring action, we have to push it through the bone from the buccal side to the palatal side. Okay, once it emerges on the palatal side, you have to engage a wire to the eyelet. It has an eyelet that is opening. From that opening, you have to secure a wire on the palate side. After securing the wire, you are going to pull it out. Okay, you are going to withdraw it. Okay, so I have withdrawn it again on the buckle side. You can see this is the parallel side wire, and this wire comes on the buckle side through the all passes. Okay, bone all passes, right? So after that, you have to repeat this procedure on the opposite side also. Right, you have to repeat it on the opposite side. Then you can see in this diagram, this is the palate occlusal aspect and this is the denture. This outer line is the denture, that is our modified Gunning splint. Keeping on the maxillary occlusal maxillary ridge, alveolar ridge, we are going to fix this Gunning splint with these wires. So these wires are twisted. This is called as per alveolar wiring. That means we are securing Gunning splint to the alveolar ridge of the maxilla with the help of a bone arm. This is regarding fixation of maxillary Gunning splint. Then coming to the mandibular Gunning splint. Mandibular Gunning splint is fixed by the process of circummandibular wiring. Circummandibular wiring. It is also essentially same procedure. You can see in this diagram, this is the mandible. That is mandibular alveolar ridge. After that, this is the lingual side, this is the tongue, and this is the lip side. Okay, I am going to take a long awl, or otherwise called as obligator awl, and I am going to pass from the inferior end of the or inferior of the lower border of the mandible. This is the lower border of the mandible, and I am going to pass through the skin approximately in the desired position, because you should not do it at the fracture site. It should be somewhat distant from the fracture site, and it should avoid injury to the facial artery and mental nerve. Okay, so after piercing skin, you have to closely place this all to the mandibular bone on the lingual side. Okay, so I have completely passed to the lingual sulcus. After passing through the lingual sulcus, I have engaged a wire. Okay, and after engaging this way, I am going to pull it out, not completely out, but out of the bone. Okay, then I am going to change the direction of this all to the buckle side, right? This is the wire pulled on the lingual side, and I am going to change the this all direction to the buckle side, and again same thing, I am going to push it on the buckle aspect. You can see in this diagram, I have pushed it on the buckle aspect. So we have two wire ends, one on the lingual side and one on the buckle side, right? After having these two wire ends, I am going to place the Gunning splint. Place the Gunning splint and this lingual wire is passed through the groove what we have prepared on the occlusal aspect. Occlusal aspect will prepare a groove so that groove will engage the wire. After engaging that and after crossing on the palatal aspect, these two wire ends are ligated on the buccal side. Okay, so this is circummandibular wiring. If the occlusal, if the impression surface of the Gunning splint and the bony anatomy or occlusal surface doesn't match, then we may use soft guttapercha in the occlusal impression surface of the Gunning splint. Okay, that means before insertion of the Gunning splint, what we are going to do, we are going to place guttapercha on the impression surface of the Gunning splint. Okay, after that we are going to heat it, or after that we are going to place it in the hot water so that it becomes soft, and put it in the oral cavity so that it can easily adapt to the surface, easily adapt to the fractured fragments, and it can stabilize the area. Okay, you can use the guttapercha also. Before placing mandibular Gunning splint, You have to suture any laceration, soft tissue lacerations, and you have to reduce the fracture fragments manually. So this is all about paralvular wiring and circummandibular wiring. With this gunning splint, you are going to fix like this. After fixation of maxillary and mandibular splints, you are going to ligate the wires to achieve the intermaxillary fixation. And you are going to maintain this immobilization for at least 4 to 6 weeks. For at least 4 to 6 weeks. After that, you are going to remove it. By that time, the bone will reunion. Okay. So this is all about gunning splint. If you like this video, hit the like button, share the video, subscribe the channel.